So we're in Colossians 2, and let's look at verses 22 and 23. Again, we've been thinking about how systems of self-improvement or spiritual discipline and so on, all these schemes for being more spiritual or improving ourselves or controlling our bad habits, all that sort of thing. And it's often portrayed even as a very as nothing to do with spiritual things. But the scriptures is warning us that these systems that ask us to put confidence in them, to fix ourselves, to save ourselves, behind them, the power of these systems is actually got spiritual dimension to it, that there are spiritual forces that want to control us, to keep us locked into systems, rules, human-based reasons and religion and human philosophies. There's spiritual forces that want to contain us in those sorts of systems of rules. So these rules they're not part of the heavenly kingdom. They're not part of eternal reality. Even if, let's say, they really are successful rules that enable us to get be successful in this life of flesh, in this world, this passing world. So say there are ways, systems that will make a lot of money and get lots of power in this world now, and you could follow rules and follow systems in order to gain treasure on earth and amass power and influence on earth now, right? There are systems like that, and there are people who are very successful and know how to know the formula to store up treasure on earth. But the Bible actually says, do not store up treasure on earth because it's got no future. If you're going to, in what you invest in and give yourself to, that's what your heart goes out to, that, and you perish with it. Like if that's all, if what you in what you give yourself to, that's what you are. So even if there are systems, because sometimes people say to me, oh, but these systems work. They enable you to get more physical power, more treasure, more influence, be more successful in this present world according to the flesh. Yeah, sure, they may well do. And there are spiritual powers that will energize those things and encourage you to invest in them. Like Satan says to Jesus in his temptations, you know, if you're, here's a way to get food when you're hungry, you know, he's miraculously make it. But you can be super popular and you could control all the nations of this world. I will enable you to do that in this world. And Jesus rejects that because his goal is something so much greater. It is to redeem this world and to go into this new creation, eternal future, not this very time-limited world of the flesh that is now. So, the rules, it says here, are all destined to perish with use and are based on merely human commands and teachings. So, even if they are successful at making us successful in this present world, all of that, that success, those rules, those philosophies, those religions, are all gonna, they're all part of this order and have no eternal future. They can drag a person down into eternal damnation, but they cannot deliver eternal life. Only Christ can do that. So such regulations, such rules, such philosophies, such systems have an appearance of wisdom there in verse 23 with their self-imposed worship or self-worship. It really is self-worship. They are focusing on you as your own savior. No, I, by following this system, you know, people will call themselves a self-made person, meaning that they have put the effort in, followed the rules, got the formula, and now they have made themselves wealthy, successful, influential, whatever it is. And it turns us in on ourselves and our own resources and our own thinking. But and there's harsh treatment of the body, you know, the idea that going to the gym or whatever and treating my, like, putting in pain now will deliver what I'm after. Well, they might get the pain now might make you strong and powerful in this world, but none of it can deliver eternal life. They lack any value in restraining sensual indulgence. So the real things that control us, the sins of the flesh, sins like our pride, our lust, our selfishness, our greed, all those things cannot be killed off by these rules. And in fact, they can feed them, make us more greedy, more proud, more self-centered. They cannot get rid of that, the flesh. Things that are designed to make the flesh successful cannot kill off the flesh. Only the cross of Christ can kill off the life of the flesh and genuinely bring us into a totally different kind of humanity that is tuned into the life of God and is after treasure in heaven that's eternal, to suddenly understand the value of eternity and to understand to number our days in this passing life. And to realize how limited that is, but how incredible. What better is one day in the courts of the living God than 1,000 days of the life of the flesh? This is deep stuff, and it's hard to grasp because we want to believe that the life of the flesh is somehow fixable and not that bad. And yet, here we're told, no, rules that focus us on fixing the flesh and making the flesh successful cannot get rid of the flesh, cannot kill it. They actually strengthen it.